Hi, welcome to Herbless Seeds. So as promised, I'm going to be talking about coconut oil and all of the wonderful healing properties and beauty benefits of this wonderful oil. Now, let me just let you know, it's kind of warm here. So the coconut oil has slightly melted, but that's okay. Now, I use coconut oil for so many things, for my skin, for my hair, for eating. I use it for my family, and it has become a big staple in our household. Now, I'm going to give you some ideas of things that you can use it for, and along with the properties. Number one, it is an antifungal and antibacterial. So, anytime someone gets a cut, a scrape, anything like that, I clean it and I slap some coconut oil on it because I feel that it helps promote the healing process and it keeps that area clean. Another thing, I brush my teeth, yes I do, with coconut oil. I do make my own toothpaste, but I also buy it. So whether I purchase it or I make my own, I use coconut oil. The quickest way is to use a little bit of baking soda, coconut oil, an essential oil that you may like, a spearmint, a peppermint, something like that for flavor, even glycerin, because glycerin has a sweet taste and it has a sticky type of texture, so it is nice to use for toothpaste. Another thing I use coconut oil for is shaving. I don't use any other shaving products. I make sure the area that I'm shaving is wet. I add a little coconut oil and I shave. The benefit of that is I don't have to reapply the coconut after I shaved unless I want to. And I use coconut oil after shaving a lot of times just to keep that area moist and to keep it clean. And you know, sometimes when you have a certain type of skin, when you shave, you may be prone to getting bumps and things like that. Coconut oil will alleviate that. One more thing. This is a bar of soap that I made not too long ago, and I use coconut oil. Coconut oil, olive oil, and various other things. I will go on to discussing that another time, but just letting you know, my soap is made of coconut oil. Something that I really enjoy making is a body scrub. Summer is pretty much out the door, but this was my essential oil for the summer. It is a grapefruit oil. My husband loves it. So I use this for a perfume, and I use it for my body scrub. So what I did is I would take a little bit of coconut oil. I would mix it with something coarse. This is a coarse kosher salt. You can use pink Himalayan salt. You can use sea salt, sugar, whatever you feel works well with your skin and it won't irritate it, to give you a nice exfoliating texture. Put a little bit of coconut oil. If you want an essential oil, rub that together. Use that to exfoliate, to take off all that dead skin cells. It's just a wonderful thing. Another thing that is a staple in my house is tea tree oil. This is an antibacteria as well. I use this with coconut oil a lot of times when someone may have sore muscles or they have a bruise or there's some type of sign of inflammation. The smell of it, it's really soothing. It does have a medicinal smell to it. You do have to get used to it. It smells like an antiseptic, and that's what you can use it for. But I do use that with coconut oil. Just talking a little bit more about coconut oil, I have used this for my hair, my teeth, my skin, for cooking. You can use it as a lubricant. You can use it for a diaper rash. The thing about the skin, I've also used it in the summer as a sunscreen. Now, I would not suggest this for someone who has very fair skin, but for myself and for my children, I use this. It helps repel the sun. There's lots of vitamin E in there. There's lots of lactic acid. So that's what I want to talk about right now, for the skin and for beauty. Now, I use coconut oil before I go to bed and I use it when I wake up. I wash my face with diluted apple cider vinegar, with a cotton ball or a face towel. I make sure my skin is still damp. just so I can maximize the absorption. And then I massage coconut oil into my face. Now, my skin is not very damp right now, but I suggest that you do it when it is damp so you can get the maximum absorption. But I massage into my face. I go through all of my little crevices. And if for some reason what you have left on your face seems too oily, blot it out with a towel so you can sleep and you don't mess up your bed pillow or your sheets. If you're okay with it, leave it there. Go to sleep. When I wake up in the morning, it's all gone, but it has penetrated my skin. And coconut oil has lactic acid, so it improves skin texture, it hydrates skin, it gives it that nice, supple look that I appreciate. Because I do not wear foundation and makeup on my skin, I like the dewy glow. And when I massage it, you can just see it all over my skin. It looks fresh, it's clean, it smells good. And I like the appearance of it. Another trick that I do, when it's sunny outside and I'm wearing my shoulders and things out, I put some on my shoulders. It's something about dewy, fresh skin to me that looks radiant and healthy. I use it on my skin. I use it on my hair. I use it on my armpits after I shave. I use it on my legs after I shave, or I use it for shaving. We brush our teeth with it, we eat with it. Like I said, you can use it as a natural lubricant because the body does not resist it. And it is an antifungal, it's fine. You can also use it in treating yeast infections. If you have any questions about that, I can respond to you and go into more detail. But it does work for that, for baby diaper rash, even times where my children, when they were babies, they may have been constipated. I would lubricate a Q-tip and bloop, and soon we would get poop. And that was with the coconut oil. If for some reason we do not use a coconut oil toothpaste, a lot of times I'll give my children a teaspoon of coconut oil after they've brushed their teeth. For some reason, they really love it. It tastes really good to them. They enjoy it. So I hope I gave you some ideas as far as how you can use coconut oil. The healing properties are wonderful. The beauty properties are great. It does keep your skin moist, hydrated, supple. I just love it. I live by it. And like I said, for my hair, I've used it as a deep conditioner. I can talk about that another time because that's a whole nother list of ingredients. But for a quick and simple body scrub, get something coarse. So you can use to exfoliate, add your coconut oil to it. If you prefer an essential oil, scrub that body, get those dead skin cells. For toothpaste, you can use a baking soda, add some type of natural sweetener, stevia, an essential oil, not this one, but something like a peppermint, a spearmint. We used to use mandarin. My kids really didn't like it. You can use it as you're making your bar soap. You can use it as an antiseptic for inflammation, mosquito bites, some type of bite, cuts, things of that nature, and just for everyday moisturizing. So I hope that that was informative. If you have any more questions, if you have comments, please leave them for me. I will answer them to the best of my ability. Just know that extra virgin coconut oil is something that's really good for you, and you should add it to your beauty regimen. I don't know what I would do without this. I've been using it for many, many years, and this is not the bottle that I purchase it in. I purchase it in a large tube from Costco, and then I transfer it to here because we use it so often. So I hope that I've answered some questions. I hope that I've given you some insight. And I hope if you have not already tried, start using coconut oil. The results, the benefits are amazing. Blessings.